sustainable development for the rest of the world will have to look very different from the West. I always like to qualify things by saying that having a non-Western perspective is not anti-Western. So 20 years ago, but even before that, I could sense that the world we live in was going to change dramatically. The rollout of the Western economic and political model across the world was going to be catastrophic for this part of the world, because, to put it bluntly, that if we had 6 billion Asians, which we will have in about 6 billion Asians attempting to live and express their freedoms as being espoused in the West, will be catastrophic. Coming from an environmental sustainability background, I began to also appreciate that much of what I had learned was unsuited to the needs of the region. Until we start to understand the rights of consumption have to be essentially curtailed, we will not have any way to talk about sustainability or environmental protection. And I argued that the West will not be able to do this, because the notion of denying people their right to consume relentlessly did not sit comfortably with the notion of liberal democracy and liberalism. For the non-Western world, what I call the rising world of global majority, we would need to have a different narrative. In it, I argued that collective well-being would have to be put ahead of individual rights. And in this end, the role of the state becomes, in my view, paramount.